Truth is, I watched you give up on me. You don't think that changed me? That shit broke me.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Your advice to overthinkers?
A quote that has helped me immeasurably. And it's from a book called The Horse, the Boy, the Fox and the Mole. The boy and a horse are in the woods. And a boy says to the horse, I can't see a way through. And the horse says, can you see your next step? And a boy says, yeah. And a horse says, then just take that.
Wow.
And it hit me.
Yeah.
All of the time, we look at the goal, we look at the future, we look at the end game, we look at how long a journey it is, and we feel overwhelmed.
Yeah.
Instead of that, just go, right, I'm not going to worry about that, because that will come. With each step, you will get closer to that. So I don't need to worry about how far away it is. All I need to focus on right now is my next step.
Skydiving in Dubai. You fly and you go up, you go up, you go up, you go up to 14,000 feet, and you notice there's a light. It's red and it's yellow and green. And the light goes green and somebody opens the door, walks you up to the end of the thing, and you're looking out down to death. And they say, on three. And they say, one, two. And he pushes you on two because people grab on three, right? And you go, and you fall out of the airplane. And in 1 second, you realize that it's the most blissful experience of your life. You're flying. You realize that the point of maximum danger is the point of minimum fear. It's bliss. It's bliss.
I had no intention of making my public, my private life, and my career so very difficult. And yet I believe, you know, as I sit here today, that I hope it's for some higher purpose. You know, it's easy to embrace hopelessness when things seem insurmountable, and yet it's actually just a matter of time until all of the elements come together for things to be all right. I mean, I believe that, you know, most difficult situations will resolve themselves if you are persistent and if you don't give up entirely. And that's what I never did. I never gave up.
Do you still get urges to do drugs?
I have not even an inkling of a desire, but I guard against it.
Are you afraid of dying?
No, not at all.
Do you think you go somewhere?
No. The one thing I can't understand, I can't grasp my mind around, I feel when you die, there's just nothing. It's like when you're asleep and you're not dreaming. But I can't imagine nothingness lasting forever.
That's
the thing that I cannot get.
I can't grasp. To not exist forever.
Listen to this. I don't give a shit. Okay? You cannot let a fear of failure, or a fear of comparison, or a fear of judgment stop you from doing what's going to make you great. You cannot succeed without this risk of failure. You cannot have a voice without the risk of criticism. And you cannot love without the risk of loss. You must go out and you must take these risks. And people will tell you to do what makes you happy. But a lot of this has been hard work. And I'm not always happy. And I don't think you should do just what makes you happy. I think you should do what makes you great. Do what's uncomfortable and scary and hard, but pays off in the long run. Be willing to fail. Let yourself fail. Fail in the way, in the place where you would want to fail. Fail, pick yourself up, and fail again. Because without this struggle, what is your success anyway?
I was born with almost 40 fractures. You name it, I broke it. I'm 15 years old, and I have osteogenesis imperfecta, a rare, incurable genetic disorder that makes my bones fragile. And hey, I know I can't do things the same way as everyone else. I mean, my parents have to lift me in and out of bed every day or when I go up the stairs at my friends' houses. But I just had to find what works for me and find how I can shine my light, what helps me cope. And for me, that was none other than music. And not only has singing, songwriting, and rapping helped me cope with my bad days, but it lets me share my feelings with everyone who might resonate with my story. In fact, when I started putting some of my covers up on YouTube, people from all over the world would send me messages that they were inspired by my music.
Without commitment, you'll never start. But more importantly, without consistency, you'll never finish. It's not easy. If it was easy, there'd be no Kerry Washington. If it was easy, there'd be no Taraji Henson, P. Henson. If it were easy, there'd be no Michael T. Williamson, no Stephen McKinley Henderson, no Russell Hornsby. If it were easy, there'd be no Denzel Washington. So keep working, keep striving, never give up, fall down 7 times, get up 8. Ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. Ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. So, keep moving, keep growing, keep learning. See you at work.
The people have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure. Then in the name of democracy, let us use that power. Let us all unite. Let us fight for a new world, a decent world, that will give men a chance to work, that will give youth a future and old age a security. By the promise of these things, brutes have risen to power, but they lie. They do not fulfill that promise. They never will. Dictators free themselves, but they enslave the people. Now let us fight to fulfill that promise. Let us fight to free the world, to do away with national barriers, to do away with greed, with hate and intolerance. Let us fight for a world of reason. A world where science and progress will lead to all men's happiness. Soldiers, in the name of democracy, let us all unite!
You guys will find that you have passions, and having a passion is a gift. I think we all have passions, and you don't get to choose them. They pick you, but you have to be alert to them. You have to be looking for them. And when you find your passion, it's a fantastic gift for you because it gives you direction, it gives you purpose. You can have a job, or you can have a career, or you can have a calling. And the best thing is to have a calling. And if you find your passion, you'll have that, and all your work won't feel like work to you.
Yesterday is history. Tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That is why it is called the present.
In love, because love really don't mean jack. See, love is just a feeling. You can love somebody, still stab them in their back. It don't really take much to love. You can love somebody just by being attached. See, loyalty is an action. You can love or hate me and still have my back. You know what I'm saying? All that mean is goddamn, like, I'd rather have loyalty over love, because love is just, it's just a feeling. It ain't really an action. You don't really, you can't, you can do the fakest shit to somebody and still tell them I love you. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, I could kill you and say I killed you because I love you so much. Right. But if I'm loyal to you, no matter how I'm feeling, I'm going to have your best interest in heart, right, because I'm being loyal to you. So that's all I was saying. Like, give me the loyalty. Fuck the love. You can love your dog. Like, I don't want love. Give me loyalty first.
You drove these to the triangle of death.
Fucking A right we did.
Kip, take these boys over to the cage, get them paid.
Right away, sir.
I was wrong about you two. Great fucking job, boys. Great fucking job.
Holy shit.
Crazy, right? $12.2 billion. All seized from the Godfather himself.
You guys call Saddam Hussein the Godfather?
Look at all this cash, bruh. Who would you call him? 2.8 million. Just sign in.
You got it.
Question. What does AEY stand for?
What do you mean? Like morally?
No. I mean, what do the letters mean?
What does IBM stand for? Nothing. It just sounds professional.
Actually, IBM stands for International Business Machines.
What'd you say?
IBM stands for International Business Machines.
Get the fuck out of here. I'm serious. You're not gonna work here. Get the fuck out of my office, you fucking nerd! Go! And for the record, AY doesn't stand for anything. Fuck! What a dick.
Do you wanna kill me?
I don't wanna kill you! What would I do without you? Go back to ripping off mob dealers? No, no. No. No, you. You complete me.
You're garbage. You kills for money.
Don't talk like one of them. You're not. Even if you'd like to be. To them, you're just a freak. Like me. They need you right now. But when they don't, they'll cast you out. Like a leper. You see, their morals, their code. It's a bad joke. You've dropped at the first sign of trouble. They're only as good as the world allows them to be. I'll show you. When the chips are down, these civilized people, they'll eat each other.
Life is seasonal. That means that no matter what you go through, it cannot last. Seasons guarantee change. Seasons give hope. Nothing remains the same in a season. Seasons are always temporary. And the key to life is outlasting the season. When you are in a dark moment, sometimes you think that that's a permanent address. But never make a permanent decision to try and solve a temporary problem. You go through a very tough moment. I mean hell on earth. Believe me, you got a choice. Am I going to make a permanent decision at this point? Or am I going to outlast this season and make it through this dark moment?
If you break, the fight isn't over. The fight is just beginning. You have the opportunity to get stronger, to show the world what you are really made of.
In control, I got a paralyzed right arm and hand. I couldn't control my career ended. I couldn't even plan for it. But when it happened, I could step back and say, okay, life, I can no longer play the game of football, but let me extract that dedication and commitment from the game. I could step back and say, my arm and my hand is paralyzed. My dedication isn't. My purpose isn't. My arm and my hand is paralyzed. My work ethic, it isn't. My purpose isn't. My arm and my hand is paralyzed. My dedication isn't. My purpose isn't. Meaning my reason for why I first started, it never got paralyzed.
First time?
There's a pretty girl.
Short, and it's fragile. And we don't know how many birthdays we have, so just, we don't have to have a birthday to celebrate. Just celebrate life. And if you haven't told someone you love them, do it now. Do it, tell people you love them. Call your friends, text your friends, hug them, kiss them.
Mithrandir. Why the halfling?
I don't know. Saruman believes that it is only a great power that can hold evil in check. But that is not what I have found. I found it is the small things, everyday deeds of ordinary folk that keeps the darkness at bay. Simple acts of kindness and love. Why, Bilbo Baggins? Perhaps it is because I'm afraid. But it gives me courage.
No losing, only learning. There's no failure, only opportunities. And there's no problems, only solutions. So to me, what failure is the mother of all success. If it wasn't for Michael Jordan getting cut from his ninth grade basketball team, he wouldn't have became Michael Jordan. You know, if it wasn't for, I seen an article the other day where they were talking about Oprah Winfrey and how she got fired because she wasn't good for television. You know, you got people like Walt Disney who got fired, if I'm not mistaken, from a newspaper saying he had no imagination. All they can do is learn and come back bigger, better, stronger, because all it's going to do is lead you in the right direction. See, if you're always winning, then you don't really understand what it is to win. You got to take those losses. You got to take those hits. There's got to be the valleys, the peaks, the ups, the downs. In order for you to, when it does happen, you go, wow, qué rico. You know, this is what it's all about. And not only that, it's never about making it, guys. It's always about maintaining it. That's the tough.
You can't curse what God has blessed. I wish I had some blessed people in here. If I had some blessed people in here, they would tell you, you are blessed in spite of who tried to curse you. You're not where you are because you don't have enemies. There's a lot of people hope you drop dead right now. And the only reason you didn't drop is because they can't curse what God.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We were all meant to shine as children do. It's not just in some of us, it's in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same, as we are liberated from our own fear. Our presence automatically liberates others.
Amazing phrase, this too shall pass. Whatever you're feeling, whether you're feeling great or whether you're feeling terribly, it's going to pass. But if truly you could never feel good about yourself ever again, why would you want to go on? Even serving other people, you do it in part because of how beautiful it feels. So helping people understand that that will pass, that there will be something beautiful again waiting for them, but that what you build your self-esteem around, what that ego is tied to, is absolutely critical. Because if you tie it to being right, if you tie it to being good, if you tie it to being pious, if you tie it to anything that is fragile or tenuous, it can go away. And then your ego is damaged. And then the psychological immune system kicks in. And then you start making really weird choices. So build your ego around something positive. Build your ego around something that is truly anti-fragile.
Thing you change about the world.
What would it change? I'd make people not hate each other because of their religion, because of their nationality, because of any stupid reason. If we could abolish hatred, we live on this gorgeous planet. There's a character I wrote called the Silver Surfer, and I always had him making those kind of remarks, philosophical things about, he was from another world. And he said, why don't we realize we're on a planet that gives us everything, food, beautiful weather, sun, everything. Why don't we enjoy it? Why do we spend time fighting and hating each other? I loved writing the Silver Surfer.
I don't need college to learn stuff, okay? Everything is available basically for free. You can learn anything you want for free. It is not a question of learning. There is a value that colleges have, which is like, can somebody work hard at something, including a bunch of sort of annoying homework assignments? You know, that's the main value of college. So I want to make sure Tesla recruiting does not have anything that says requires university, because that's absurd. But there is a requirement of evidence of exceptional ability. Like, you just can't, if you're trying to do something exceptional, they must have evidence of exceptional ability.
A salary is the drug they give you when they want you to forget about your dreams. Because it's very easy to stay in that world where somebody is mitigating your risk. You just have to perform certain tasks, do them well for a third of your day, and they will feed you a
chance. This is your shot. This is your moment. This is your time. This is your place. This is your opportunity.
This is my time. This is my moment. Tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. Ain't no such thing as tomorrow. We only got today. It's your dream. If you want to have it, get your butt up and make it happen. If you want to have it, rise and grind.
You still got work to do.
stay on that basketball court. Stay on that football field. It's grind season, homie.
But I want to talk about a few other things. Because like I said, man, sometimes we can focus so much on the cars and the clothes and the money and the materialistic things that we forget about our happiness. We forget about our peace of mind. We forget about family. Shit, sometimes we forget about our mental health. And see, what I learned about this is that when we equate our success and our value and our worth to these things that other people define as success, no matter how much of it you have, you'll never feel like you have enough.
Have any regrets?
No. Don't have time to regret. We move on. Because we are acceptable for what we are, not what we think we should be. I'm accepted in myself by what I am, but not as I think I should be, because that's a lie. I'm a sinner. I'm an old sinner. Uh-huh. I've done some bad things. I've done some good things. So, you know, you just forgive yourself and move on.
I believe in manifestation. I believe in, you know, putting a rocket of desire out into the universe. And you get it when you believe it. You get it when you believe you have it. And that's the key, is like people still, they sit around going, when's it going to come? 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 And that's the wrong way. You're facing the wrong way. You're facing away from it. You have to go, it's here, it's here.
And he said, Cristiano, we have money, we have everything, we have fame. And he said, I have millions and billions, but the most important thing is the family. Keep your family healthy, good, and take care of your family, because this is the most important thing in the world. A part of that, of course, you have your life, your private life, you have your girlfriend, you have your cars, your houses, your fame. But in the beginning, your family.
You have a dream, and the dream isn't something you dream and then it happens. The dream is something you never knew was going to come into your life. Dreams always come from behind you, not right between your eyes. It sneaks up on you. But when you have a dream, it doesn't often come at you screaming in your face, this is who you are, this is what you must be for the rest of your life. Sometimes a dream almost whispers. And I've always said to my kids, the hardest thing to listen to, your instincts, your human personal intuition, always whispers, it never shouts. Very hard to hear. So you have to, every day of your lives, be ready to hear what whispers in your ear. It very rarely shouts. And if you can listen to the whisper, and if it tickles your heart, and it's something you think you want to do for the rest of your life, then that is going to be what you do for the rest of your life, and we will benefit from everything.
I've ever been called dumb, unattractive, overweight, unworthy, untalented. Well, so have I. Whatever you do, don't let negativity of people projecting their own self-doubts on you deter you from your focus. I know those moments are painful. And you're human and it hurts like hell, but now is the time to turn those criticisms into fuel and motivation to become a beautiful beast.
Share your dreams and your goals with everybody. Like, everybody doesn't deserve to have that type of access to you. Everybody doesn't deserve to be able to treat something that's so fragile, because they won't treat it with the same care like you will. They won't see the things that you see when you dream. And see, this is going to fuck a lot of people up, but sometimes it's going to be your family and your friends. Sometimes it's going to be the people that you never thought would see it, that you never thought would doubt you, or never, that you never thought would take your dreams and treat them like they were nothing.
My mom said, you need to get a job. I said, I already have a job. I'm just not getting paid yet. Man, I'm working on my dream. That's my job. If I'm going to pay attention to my nightmare, I should be able to work on my dream. Well, some one of them is going to take my energy. I would rather give my energy to my dream than my
life. I was taught it about ferocity, viciousness, fear, inflicting stuff. And all my life I found that that was a lie. And I found that it was all about being humble and subservient and giving to people and loving people and forgiving people for mistakes and shit. And coming to grips with that is just overwhelming, you know. Sometimes I cry a lot because I've been living a life that was wrong all these years.
And now, I mean, I think you can show so many younger kids that are going through that same thing.
I hope so. I hope so.
I feel like if I put my mind to something and I really do the work, I can accomplish something. My primary business is based on a lot of failure and success, right? But it's never for lack of effort. And as long as I do everything I can to do my best, then I feel pretty darn good about the effort. And sometimes I win and succeed, and sometimes I don't. But I always felt like if I didn't do everything I could to prepare, then that's when I had regret. And that's when I felt disappointed in myself. But, you know, we are blessed to be able to have a fresh start every day. You know, you just got to be able to kind of have confidence in yourself and belief in yourself, surrounding yourself with good people.
We need more in this world. Leaders. We're living in a society where it's two major words, followers and likes. My mother told me to never be a follower. And let me tell you something, and again to the kids, I'm sorry, but I got to say it because you feel my passion. I never gave a fuck if you like me or not. If I'm focused on something and I know I'm doing the right thing, trying to help people and you don't see it, well then, hey, what? God bless you, but we're going to keep it moving. We're going to keep it pushing. Own your life. Own your future. Own your destiny. Be a leader. Lead by example. That's what the world needs now more than ever.
Life is a book. You got chapters in your life. And the reason why I say life lessons, because each chapter, there should be a lesson after that chapter in your life.
Mm-hmm.
If something bad happened, what did you learn from that bad mistake? And how did you improve on that to move on to the next chapter in your life and be better?
Me or nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
Sell me this pen.
It's an amazing pen. It's for professionals.
Sell me this pen.
It's a nice pen. You can use the pen to write down thoughts from your life so you can remember.
Brad, show him how it's done. Boom. Sell me that pen. Watch.
Go on. You sell this fucking pen?
That's my boy right there.
This pen?
Fucking sell anything.
Would you do me a favor? Why'd you name down that napkin for me?
I don't have a pen.
Exactly. Supply and demand, my friend.
You know what I'm saying? Shit. He's creating urgency.
Everybody want to know what I would do if I didn't win. I guess we'll never know.
One, I look in the mirror. On the other side of it, what an opportunity we have, because tomorrow's the first day of the rest of our lives. So what an opportunity we have to practice what he preached.
We were put here for a reason. God created man, and God intends for us to love all mankind. And by being in a loving mood, caring for one another, that's our purpose for life. We should care for one another, and we should love one another.
Vida, you work hard for it, or you don't work hard for it? Well, me and my brother, we work hard for our stuff. It don't come easy. In life, you have to work. Vida! You want to be the shark of the ocean or the fish of the ocean? And right now we want to be the shark. Take over everything. Strength, no weakness. Power, the muscles. Have to have that mindset. So you're going to come in here and dominate. When you see it, oh, no. Don't put yourself down. You want to beat yourself. Keep yourself up, pumped, and ready for any challenge that comes.
In any fight,
It's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that itch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life anymore, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that itch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face. Now, I can't make you do it. You gotta look at the guy next to you. Look into his eyes. Now, I think you're gonna see a guy who will go that inch with you. You're gonna see a guy who will sacrifice himself for this team because he knows when it comes down to it, you're gonna do the same for him. That's the team, gentlemen. And either we heal now, as a team, or we will die as individuals.
Shit, that looks good. That looks really good. It's clean and simple. No Disneyland, no live new girls. Watch. What'd you write? Relationship status. Interested in. This is what drives life in college. Are you having sex or aren't you? It's why people take certain classes and sit where they sit and do what they do when at some center, you know? That's what the Facebook is gonna be about. People are gonna log on because after all the cake and watermelon, there's a chance they're actually gonna
get laid.
Meet a girl. Yes.
That is really good.
And that was it.
What do you mean?
It's ready.
It's ready?
Yeah.
Right now?
That was it. And here's the masthead.
You made a masthead?
Yeah.
Eduardo Severin, co-founder and CFO.
Yeah.
You have no idea what that's going to mean to my father.
Sure I do.
And maybe we're going to the game.
Where are we going now?
To see someone about my job.
I don't understand.
You don't understand what?
Are we going to the game?
I said possibly we're going to the game. You know what possibly means?
Like probably?
No, probably means there's a good chance that we're gone. Possibly means we might not. What does probably mean?
It means we have a good chance.
What does possibly mean?
I know what it means.
What does it mean?
It means that we're not going to the game.
How did you get so smart?
Because you're smart.
We do not practice empathy. What does empathy look like? Here's the lack of empathy. This is normal in our business world. You walk into someone's office, someone walks into our office and says, your numbers have been down for the third quarter in a row. You have to pick up your numbers, otherwise I can't guarantee what the future will look like. How inspired do you think that person is to come to work the next day? Here's what empathy looks like. You walk into someone's office, someone walks into your office and says, your numbers are down for the third quarter in a row. Okay? I'm worried about you. What's going on? We all have performance issues. Maybe someone's kid is sick. Maybe they have problems in their marriage. Maybe one of their parents is dying. We don't know what's going on in their lives. And of course it will affect performance at work. Empathy is being concerned about the human being, not just their output.
Without commitment, you'll never start, but more importantly, without consistency, you'll never finish. It's not easy. If it was easy, there'd be no Kerry Washington. If it was easy, there'd be no Taraji Henson, P. Henson. If it were easy, there'd be no Michael T. Williamson, no Stephen McKinley Henderson, no Russell Hornsby. If it were easy, there'd be no Denzel Washington. So, keep working, keep striving, never give up, fall down 7 times, get up 8. Ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. Ease is a greater threat to progress than hardship. So keep moving, keep growing, keep learning. See you at work.
I'm serious.
Yeah, no, I'm serious too. Seriously, how much money you make?
I told you, 70,000. Well, technically 72,000 last month, something like that.
You made 72 grand in 1 month.
Yeah.
I tell you what. You show me a pay stub for $72,000 on it, I quit my job right now and I work for you. Hey, Paulie, what's up? No, yeah, everything's fine. Hey, listen, I quit.
And he did quit his job.
Yeah, no, I'm great.
Which I thought was a little weird. I mean, I just met this fucking guy.
Oh, fuck.
Stage just because of talent or ability. We're up here because of 4 a.m. We're up here because we had a dream and never ever rest in the middle. Rest at the end, not in the middle.
And I'm not scared.
But you took on a croc.
And I was scared doing it. If you ain't scared of a croc biting you on the face, you ain't alive. Listen, kid. You can't get rid of fear. It's like Mother Nature. You can't beat her or outrun her. But you can get through it. You can find out what you're made of.
Don't hide. Live. Follow the sun. You'll make it to tomorrow.
You follow the light.
Losing, only learning. There's no failure, only opportunities. And there's no problems, only solutions. So to me, what failure is the mother of all success. If it wasn't for Michael Jordan getting cut from his ninth grade basketball team, he wouldn't have became Michael Jordan. You know, if it wasn't for, I seen an article the other day where they were talking about Oprah Winfrey and how she got fired because she wasn't good for television. You know, you got people like Walt Disney, who got fired, if I'm not mistaken, from a newspaper saying he had no imagination. All it can do is learn and come back bigger, better, stronger, because all it's gonna do is lead you in the right direction. See, if you're always winning, then you don't really understand what it is to win. You gotta take those losses, you gotta take those hits. There's gotta be the valleys, the peaks, the ups, the downs, in order for you to, when it does happen, you go, wow, qué rico. You know, this is what it's all about. And not only that, it's never about making it, guys. It's always about maintaining it. That's the tough.
Keys to success in the broker business. First of all, you gotta stay relaxed.
Yeah.
You jerk off?
Do I jerk off? Yeah. Yeah, I jerk off, yeah.
How many times a week?
Like, three or four times, maybe.
I'm gonna pump those numbers up. Those are rookie numbers in this racket. I myself, I jerk off at least twice a day.
Wow.
Once in the morning, right after I work out, and then once right after lunch.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I want to. That's not why I do it. Mm-hmm. I do it because I fucking need to. Think mm-hmm. about it. You're dealing with numbers all day long. Mm-hmm. Decimal points, high frequencies, bang, 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 fucking digits, all very acidic, above the shoulders, mustard shit.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
It kind of can wake some people out.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You got to feed the geese to keep the blood flowing.
Mm-hmm.
I keep the rhythm below the belt.
Associate tells me you're interested in one of our stocks.
Your wife's on parade.
I will call her back. MSC sounds like it might be interesting.
Might be. Might be doesn't sell stock at the rate MSC is going for, Dr. Jacobs. We're talking very high volume here.
Oh, well, I still have to run it by my people.
That's great, Doc, if you want to miss yet another opportunity here and watch your colleagues get rich doing clinical trials,
then don't buy a share and hang up the phone.
Well, hold on a second now. I didn't say that. I just want to talk about it some more.
Honestly, Doc, I don't have the time.
This stock is blowing up right now. The whole firm's going nuts. Hold on. Let me open up the door to my office. See that, Doc? That's my trading floor. Now I have a million calls to make to a million other doctors who are already in the know. I can't walk you through this right now.
I'm sorry.
Okay, let's...
Worry about the man who works from his home office and a little boy comes in one day. He's 8 years of age. He says, "Hey, Daddy, any chance we can play catch?" Daddy says, "Sorry, son, I'm busy." Next day, little boy comes in. "Hey, Daddy, any chance we can play catch?" "Sorry, son, I'm busy." Third day in a row, little boy comes in, knocks on Daddy's door. Daddy says, "Son, told you yesterday, told you the day before, I'm busy, I can't play catch." He says, "Oh, Dad, I wasn't going to ask you to play catch today." He goes, "Oh, what were you going to ask me?" He says, I was going to ask you how much money you earn an hour. Daddy says, son, that's a very rude question, but I earn $50 an hour so I can put a roof over your head and food in your tummy. So please get him out of my office. I got work to do. Little boy doesn't knock on that door for a week, a month. 2 months goes by before that little boy knocks on daddy's door. He says, hey, daddy, yes, son. Daddy, over the last 2 months, I've been mowing lawns. I've been pruning trees. I've been doing every single chore that my mom has asked of me, and I've been able to raise $25. Daddy, I was wondering if I could give you this $25. Could I please just have half an hour of your time? And daddy, could we please go and play catch?
One day, a man was drowning in the water. And a boat came by and said, do you need any help? He said, no, thank you. God will save me. And another boat came by and said, do you need any help? And he said, no, thank you. God will save me. Then he drowned and went to heaven. And he said, God, why didn't you save me? And God said, I sent you two big boats, you know me. Do you like it?
Yeah, it's very funny.